the action researcher takes up this responsibility of conducting the research in order to solve the social problem. Though his main responsibility is of course the grassroots level worker, and the new responsibility that he or she adds on is that of researching, so researcher. But apart from these two roles, there are many other roles that the action researcher plays in the whole process of conducting the action research. We will see which are those roles. The first one is that of a planner. Now, we had also seen in the cycle of action research that planning is the first stage. So, the responsibility of planning the whole action plan is that of that action researcher. He plans about the how exactly the plan will be conducted, on the timeline, on the logistics, on the human resources and so on. So during the stage of planning, this role of planner comes to a greater extent, and one plans all the details that are needed while conducting the actual plan. The next role that the action researcher takes up is that of the leader. Now, this role comes right in the beginning, because he identifies the situation which needs some improvement or which could be bettered, and thus he feels that this situation can be improved, and he is the one who can do something about improving this situation. And thus, from this point of view, the action researcher plays the role of that of a leader in this case. The next role that the action researcher plays is that of a catalyzer. As we know, the role of a catalyst in a chemical process. What does the catalyst do? The catalyst, by its mere presence in the situation, it accelerates the reaction between the two elements. So, similarly, just by merely the presence of action researcher, but also his contribution in terms of action plan, one starts improving the situation or takes some steps for improving the situation, and thus he plays the role of that of catalyzer. While the action plan is actually being implemented, the action researcher plays the role of that of a facilitator. So, he facilitates the situation, he makes the persons who are involved or the students who are involved to undergo the process of learning by themselves. And then he looks into the aspects that how I can make this situation easier for the students, how it can be better for the students and so on. And thus the role of facilitator is being conducted by the action researcher. If it is an educational action research, the action researcher plays the role of that of a teacher, because as we have been seeing right through the beginning, that it is the action research is conducted when the person feels it is my situation, my problem, and I have to do something about it. So, here in this case, it is in educational situation, it would be the teacher who would feel this, because he is the person working at a grassroots level. So, here is maybe the teacher would feel that this is my situation, my students, and if they are not understanding a particular content, it is my responsibility. So, he also takes up the responsibility of conducting the action plan. And from that point of view, he becomes the teacher in that situation. The first step in the action research is the planning. So, even while planning, he designs the complete teaching learning scenario. Now, this will take care of not only the detailed minute-to-minute program that is going to happen, but also designs especially the instructional material that is needed, or maybe at times, if suppose it is something ICT based, so designing those interactions between the students and teachers, that is the responsibility of the action researcher in this case. So from that point of view, he works as a designer. Now, while actually implementing the action plan, the action researcher needs to be absolutely open to the criticism, or maybe the reactions that are coming, the kind of responses the students are giving, the kind of interactions they are having with one another. And as we have already said, this is a very crucial stage, because this is the only time when he would get to listen to their minds. So from that angle, during this stage, the action researcher becomes the listener to them. And unless one is really a good listener, the real comments on the action plan or the material that has been designed and developed and being utilized for the group, they will never reach the action researcher, and they will not provide any ground for the further improvement. So the role of a listener, once the action is conducted, then the action researcher should give the opportunity to the participants to react upon the experience they went through or the exposure they went through. And during that phase, it should be absolutely listening rather than giving his or her explanations about why it was done in a particular manner. So that focus role of listening is absolutely a must in this case. While the action plan is being implemented, there is lot of interaction between the students. It is not necessarily that all the interaction would be verbal. Rather, a lot of feedback or lot of reactions to the action plan and modality in which the whole session has been planned would come through the non-verbal communication from the students. Now, this non-verbal communication or non-verbal reactions would be with the action researcher, because he would be the teacher also during that time. And they are also amongst the students themselves. So the teacher here needs to be a very keen observer about how they are interacting. Suppose they have to handle some material, then how they are handling that material. If some write-up is given to them, how they are reading, whether they are comfortable with it, what are their reactions to it. So apart from this verbal feedback from them, which would come definitely at the end of the action plan, the action researcher should be a very keen observer of these minute details, that how they are handling. Suppose the action researcher has planned to keep certain things on the right hand side of the students while they are working in the laboratory. Now, whether the students are actually finding it easy picking it up from the right hand side, or will it be more advisable to keep it somewhere else? Or suppose a common pool of material has been kept, which is to be shared by all the students, then while they are sharing the material, whether everybody is getting an equal opportunity, equal time and enough time for handling them, that material, or whether independent material would be better, that decision would be taken by the researcher later. But unless one has the minute observations about how exactly the things are being done, especially during the implementation stage, one would not get these inputs for further improvement. The next role that the action researcher has to take over is that of a synthesizer. Now, as we know, the process of synthesis means collecting the small parts and making the whole out of it. So here the action researcher needs to take up the role where one can pick up the parts from, say, his or her observations about the participants, listening from them, that would give him some inputs, his own experiences while conducting the action plan or implementing the action plan, the reflections upon it. So there are many sources from which the action researcher would get the say data or inputs, feedback, the seeding for the further improvement. It is now the responsibility and depends on the capacity of the action researcher, how one is able to synthesize all these parts and make it a whole, and then take the lessons for further improvement in the action plan. The last role that the action researcher takes up is that of a reporter. Now, the action researcher has taken a lot of efforts in terms of right from designing, implementing, actually observing, and then later on reflecting upon his own practices. These whole efforts need to be documented, and they need to be shared with the other practitioners in the field. It is possible that maybe the action researcher has taken up this problem or taken up this issue for solving because he felt that it was my situation and my problem and I want to solve this problem. But there may be many such other practitioners in the field who may be facing the similar problem. The action researcher reporting about his own efforts, the success, the failures, the learning through the whole process would be definitely forming a great fund of knowledge for those other practitioners who are facing maybe similar problems. And that is why the role of a reporter is absolutely must for the action researcher. So thus we have seen that though there is a role of a researcher that the practitioner has taken up additionally, these are the many other roles that come along with the role of a researcher that need to be taken up the responsibility for and also implemented to the best possible manner so that the action research becomes the most efficient effort and gives a good results to the researcher so that they can be used for the further improvement. Action research is conducted by the practitioners in the field. When we consider this in the context of educational situations, the teacher is the practitioner, teacher is the person who is working at the grassroots level. During the process of action research, there is an important stage of reflection as we have seen earlier. And this reflection is not only about the practices that are happening, but it is about the teacher's own thinking, his own beliefs, his own perceptions about the situations. And thus taking up the action research is a part of the professional development of a teacher, because the action research gives an opportunity for the teacher to take a little closer look of the way practices are in the field and how its impact is on the students and how they can be improved further. During this improvement process, they eventually also improve the teacher or the practitioner in the form of a teacher, and thus taking up the action research helps in his own professional development and helps in identifying at times even lacunas and drawbacks in himself or herself and keep working on them. And thus it also keeps the teacher in the role of the lifelong learner, because the teacher is ready to learn through his mistakes, her mistakes, and improve upon the action plan and keep working on that. So as the cycle further progresses, for the first to second cycle of action research, third, fourth, and so on, that is also an indicator of the teacher's own learning. And that's how the learning path progresses in the context of teacher.